In this clip, I will show how the synchronous product can be used in modeling. So let's apply the synchronous product on the pedestrian crossing. How can we divide the problem into smaller parts? Remember, we have a traffic light for cars, we have a traffic light for pedestrians, and a button for pedestrians. And we can build small LTSs for each of them. And actually, the LTS for the cars is already given. So we can call that one L1, traffic light for cars. Note that we still have to add a final state. Let's say we're happy when it is red, as then it is safe. Next, for pedestrians, we only have two colors between which we alternate, so we can create a simple LTS, L2, traffic light for pedestrians, and we make it red, it can turn green, and it can go back to red. And again, we say that red is the final state, as then the situation is safe. Similarly, the button for pedestrians is either pushed or unpushed, so that's this model. In order to apply the synchronous product, we need to prepare the systems so that we can merge them. First, we label all the actions. In the traffic light for cars, we label the action to turn green A, to turn yellow B, etc. And similarly, we label the actions of the other LTSs with unique labels. Next, we relabel the actions that represent the same action. So in our case, let's look at the light for pedestrians and the button. Is the unpushing of the button, action G, a real action? No, it happens when the light of the pedestrian changes. So we can either join it with action D or with action E. If we join it with action D, then the button can be pushed again while the traffic light is green. As this does not feel natural to me, I let it coincide with action E. If the light turns red again, the button can be pushed. So instead of calling the unpushed action G, I relabel it to E. Next, we need to annotate the states with the action of the others. When do you allow the other actions if they are not shared like action E? So in state P, the traffic light of the pedestrian is allowed to change actions D and E. Anyone can push the button, actions D, action F. So I add a self loop to it with actions D, E and F. In state R, we only allow the pushing of the button since otherwise it would be unsafe. So a self loop with action F. And similarly for Q. In a pedestrian light, the car's light may cycle only if the light is red. Hence, in state W, we add a self loop with actions A, B, and C. And we also allow the button to be pushed, so action F is added as well. For the button system, if the button is not pushed, the car's light may cycle, but the pedestrian's light not. Only if the button is pushed, that light may turn to green. So we add a system, we say A, B, C over there. Last, if the button is pushed, we allow the car's light to cycle and let the pedestrian light turn green. Hence, actions A, B, C, and D are allowed. However, we don't want the cars to get green if the button is pushed, so remove action A from state Z. Now we can create the synchronous product. Again, I start with creating a table. So I have L1, I have state P, and with P I can do an A to state R. I can do a D to state P, I can do an E to state P, I can do an F to state P as well. In R, I can do a B to Q, and I can do an F back to R. In Q, I can do a C that leads me to state P, I can do an F that leads me to state Q. In system 2, I have state W. And in W, I can do a D that leads me to X. And I can do actions A, B, C, and F. That all leads me to state W. In X, I can do an E that leads to state W. In L3, I have states Y. I can do an F that moves to Z. And I can do actions A, B, and C that all lead to Y. In Z, I have actions E that leads me to Y, and I have actions B, C, and D that all leads to Z again. Next, my begin state is P for L1, It is W for L2 and it is Y for L3. And the end state is the same as the beginning state, the initial states P, W and Y. So we start at P, W, Y. That's step 3, creating the actions. In P, W, Y, I can do an A. So in P, doing an A leads me to R. In W, doing an A leads me to W. And in Y, doing an A leads me to Y. Action D is not allowed in Y, so I can't do it. E is not allowed. F is the only one allowed. So I also can do an F. So P leads me with an F to P. W with an F leads me to W. And Y leads me with an F to Z. The next state I'm going to use is RWY. In RWY, I can do action B that leads me to Q. In W, I can do a B which leads to W. And in Y, I can do a B that leads me to Y. So B is enabled. So I can do a B. R leads to Q. W leads to W. And Y leads to Y. I also can do an F because it is enabled. It leads me from R with an F to R in L1. W leads me with an F to W. And then Y doing an F results in Z. So I can do an F. Remain an R for the first one. W remains the same. And then Y I move to Z. So RYW is done. RWY I mean. Let's move to PWZ. PWZ. In P I can do an A. But I can't do an A in Z. So A is not enabled. D is enabled. I can do it in P, I can do it in W, and I can do it in Z. So D is allowed. And D leads me to P with a D to P, W with a D to X, and Z with a D to Z. And all the other actions are not allowed. Now we move to the next state, QWY. In Q I can do a C and an F. In W I can only do the, I can also do the C and the F. And in Y I can also do the C and the F. So with a C, Q leads to P. W with a C leads to W. And Y with a C leads to Y. Doing the F in QWY gives me a Q for the first one, a W for the second one, and for the third it gives me Z. And then QWY is also done. Now let's move to RWZ. RWZ. In R I can do B and F. If I look to the system in W, I can also do B and F. But in Z I can't do F, so B is the only one allowed by all three of them. So B is allowed, R with a B leads to Q, W with a B leads to W, and Z with a B leads to Z. Now we do P, X, Z. In P we can do A, D, E and F. In X you can only do E, and in Z we can also do E. So E is the only action allowed. We can do an E. In P, doing the E leads to P. In X, doing the E leads to W. And in Z, doing the E leads to Y. So that one is done as well. PWY was the initial state, so already covered. QWZ, I haven't had yet, so QWZ. In Q, I can do C and F. In W, I can only do, I can also do C and F. And in Z I can do only C. So C is the only one allowed. So we do C. For the first one it leads to P. For W it leads to W. And for the third with Z going with C to Z. Q QWZ done. QWZ already did. PWY is already there. What's the initial? And PWZ is already done. So I don't have any new states, so I can start drawing. So let's draw. The initial state is PWY. I can do an A. That leads me to RWY. And I can do an F. And that leads to PWZ. In RWY, I can do a B. That leads me to QWY. Or I can do an F. And that leads to RWZ. In PWZ, I can do a D. And that leads me to PXZ. PXZ. In QWY, I can do a C to PWY. So that's this one. And with an F, I get into QWZ. That's this one. In RWZ, I can do a B that leads to QWZ with a B. In PXZ, I can move with an E to PWY. And in QWZ, I can move with a C to PVZ. So that's that one, with a C. I have marked the beginning state, the initial state, and I need to mark the end state. That is the same one, so I add a circle around it. So this is the model. So this is the resulting synchronous product, L1 times L2 times L3. Let's study the model in more detail. First, we see that state P is the red light for cars. So let's annotate this in the model. Next, R resembles green for the cars and Q yellow for the cars. So let's add those as well. State W reflects red for the pedestrians and state X green for them. So we can add those. Last, state Z resembles that the button is pushed. And for the actions, action F resembles the pushing of the button. We can add them as well. So this is the annotated model. Now compare this model with the models of the first lecture. What do you notice? Use the reflective modeling cycle to compare the results. How do they differ? Which one do you prefer? And notice we now have three different models for the same situation. So to conclude this clip, divide and conquer is an approach we often follow in modeling. We can also do this with labeled transition systems using the synchronous product. This approach consists of four steps. Model each part as a labeled transition system, relabel the actions that are the same, annotate the individual labeled transition systems, so when are actions of the others allowed, and create a synchronous product. Remember that this approach does not replace the reflective modeling cycle. Instead, the synchronous product offers a tool in your toolbox to ensure your model is correct. Still, you need to go through the stages of the reflective modeling cycle to do the actual modeling. With this technique, divide and conquer becomes possible. So, good luck modeling!